While some might be sitting by their fireplace in their pajamas this weekend, others will be joining the Streets Alive mission here in Lethbridge at Exhibition Park tomorrow, where people will walk either 2, 5, or 10 kilometers as part of the Coldest Night of the Year fundraiser.
For the people that we serve, -3 is still cold because they're out in it for hours. And a lot of our clients get to the place where they are so cold they don't remember being warm. And an hour with Coldest Night of the Year, to just sort of get just a taste of that, I think helps a lot of people be a lot more empathetic.
Staff say the one-night fundraiser has helped past participants grow in empathy. But for Streets Alive staff member Shauna Clark, her love for the clients she serves and the place she works came from more than a one-night stand.
You know, my life became very unmanageable and a mess, and I ended up on the streets. I was really lost and broken.
And she'd get clean, and then she'd relapse, and we might not see her for 6 or 7 months, or we might not see her for a year.
Clark was abused from a young age and turned to drugs and alcohol. After ending up in jail, she met a staff member from Streets Alive. Clark came in and out for 10 years, but then she came to her end.
Almost 3 years ago, I came through these doors. I was on a 7-month binge, and I was dying.
The founders of Streets Alive, Ken and Julie Kissick, brought her to a detox center where she started getting professional help.
And he ran all the tests and stuff, and the doctor told me if I go back out drinking and using drugs that I was going to die because my organs were shutting down.
Eventually, they get to a place where they have to make a choice that they want to really be different. And then that's when we can kick in more resources, counseling. But the big thing is just to love them. And what we've seen here is an individual who had a horrific lifestyle and life, who's now turned around. She enjoys her life. She's a great asset to the mission. She's just been married.
You know, they always saw something in me that I didn't see in myself, and they always had more like hope and faith in things I did. Like, they'd seen me do really good and they'd seen me do really bad, right? And so they believed in me. If I came here and I said, okay, I'm done, or I'm ready to try and quit, that's when they would help me. You know, when I was out there doing what I wanted to do, they couldn't help me, right?
Each time back, nothing changed for us. We still loved her. We still cared for her. We still wanted to see her move forward. When we want to see a life changed, you have to be committed. You're all in.
The staff members we spoke with all said their clothing mission is to thank for poverty being disguised in Lethbridge. Clients are free to access services at Streets Alive, getting up to one new outfit every day. The mission also provides food, shelter, emotional, spiritual support, and community. Streets Alive has been running since 1989. For Bridge City News, I'm Josie Foster.